Before fleeing to Norway, Mohammad Mustafa was one of a handful of Iranian defence lawyers who continued to work against the death penalty in the face of adversity. Over the last year, the restrictions imposed by the Iranian authorities, targeting young people, women and human rights activists, made it impossible for him to continue working.
نقص حقوق بشر در سال گذشته در زمانی که آقای لاریجانی ریاست قوه قضاییه را به عهده گرفت بسیار ناخوشایند بود. خیلی ها بیگناه به زندان رفتند، اسیر شدند، به گروگان گرفته شدند، مورد شکنجه قرار گرفتند، دادرسی‌های ناعادلانه‌ای داشتند، حکم‌های سنگینی گرفتند که مستحق اونها نبودند.
He fled Iran when the authorities detained three of his relatives and issued a warrant for his arrest. He escaped over the mountains into Turkey before finally finding refuge in Norway.
Sadly, his departure from Iran is yet another of the many, many human rights defenders and human rights activists who have had to leave Iran in the course of 2010, which had been the subject of numerous reports and urgent appeals by Amnesty International.
من کاری که انجام میدادم کار کاملا انسانی بود. اصلا وارد حوزه سیاسی نمیشدم و هدفم این بود که یک نفر از مرگ نجات پیدا کنه. و غیر از کسانی که در سن زیر 18 سال بودن، خوشبختانه حدود 50 نفر رو تونستم از مجازات اعدام و قصاص و سنگسار نجات بدم در چند ساله گذشته.
محمد was outspoken in his defense of Sakine Mohammadi Ashtiani, the much-publicized mother of two, sentenced to death by stoning, who recently appeared on Iranian state television in a so-called interview that appeared to implicate her in the murder of her husband.
Now, in the case of Sakine Mohammadi Ashtiani, luckily she has another lawyer. With respect to Ibrahim Hamidi, a juvenile offender who's been sentenced in connection with sodomy charges, in which there have been a number of witnesses who have withdrawn their evidence, it does remain to be seen because he has no other lawyer. And indeed, there are other cases, Mohammad Reza Haddadi, and indeed others who also have no lawyers. And we are very concerned about those individuals.
من چندین ایمیل گرفتم از دوستانم که میگفتن که این موکلت الان نگرانه، اون موکلت الان نگرانه. خیلی از همکاران من اعلام آمادگی کردن که بخوام به اونا کمک بکنن. ولی متاسفانه باز هم کاری که دستگاه قضایی کردیم بودش که تمام پرونده های من از دفترم برد و یک به گونه دست های من رو حتی از اینجا کوتاه کرد که نتونم به اونها کمک بکنم. 2300 تا پرونده ای که داشتم وقتی که یک نفر رو اعدام می کردن واقعا نمیتونستم غذا بخورم، نمیتونستم بخوابم.
Amnesty International has worked with Mohammad Mustafai for a number of years on some of the cases that he has been working on. His loss to Iran, to the judicial system, to the promotion and protection of human rights in Iran is palpable. It's a very important loss.
خیلی از کودکان و از زنانی که در کشور ما هستند قربانیان نقض قانون هستند، قربانیان هستند که اجتماع اونها رو قربانی کرده، بنابراین اونها نیاز به حمایت داشتن و دارن و خواهند داشت.